Oh, okay, thanks. That was quick.
We are back live from CES in Las Vegas for 2018. Hello there, this is Digital Trends, and we are talking exactly that, all the digital trends happening this year. We've actually got someone very new at the table here. Thank you so much for joining me, Les Xu. Now, you are the photography, travel, and tech editor, or a sectional editor for Digital Trends.
Correct.
Now, I've missed you this entire convention so far. What have you been up to?
I've been hiding a lot of the time.
Fair enough, I'm scary.
I've been looking for a Starbucks that's not busy. But, you know, I've been running around quite a bit, checking, you know, a lot of the new imaging products, you know, a lot of 360 cameras, AR, VR cameras, even traditional cameras, and then also, you know, jumping into a little bit of like connected home, looking at all the things there. There's just so much to see, and every year I feel like I've seen like 5%.
Yes.
Of, you know, what's there. And
so big here. There's a lot to cover. Thank goodness we have digitaltrends.com/CES, where it's just a hub of all the things happening there. Let's talk more about the connected home.
Yeah.
To do that, we're actually going to talk to GE Lighting. I've got Jeff Patton, who is the GM Connected Home Product Management, which is a huge title. So I have a feeling you're a very important person, Jeff. Let's talk about the connected home with GE Lighting.
Yes, well, thank you. Thank you very much, Maude. I'm very happy to be here.
Ah, thank you. So CES is obviously huge. What did you announce this year?
Well, we actually announced an extension to our new smart home product line. We just announced a new smart switch that allows you to actually turn off your smart light bulbs without losing control.
I didn't know there was smart light bulbs.
There are smart light bulbs. Yes.
When did that happen?
Yeah, 2018. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Good. Wow.
Yes.
Keep going.
They're so smart. You can control them with an app, control them with your voice. There's so many things you can do with them. Yeah. And then even beyond that, we actually also announced smart ceiling fixtures. So what this would be is you can imagine a recessed can, perhaps, in the ceiling of your home, or even a surface mount fixture with voice assistance embedded within them, working with all the main players out there to deliver that. So I think with these new products out, they really transform the experience for consumers in their home as they continue to realize really some wonderful new benefits from all these smart lighting products to deliver things like better sleep for yourself, to really create more experiences like a little romance when you might need that, calm the family down when you might need them. We think it's really sort of a whole new area for consumers to explore.
And when you're thinking connected home, you don't actually think about the light bulb, but the bulb is actually sort of like the perfect solution for a smart home, wouldn't you say?
Oh, absolutely. What people sometimes really take for granted is that lighting is in every room of the home. It's ubiquitous. And so really it makes it sort of native to all of these different experiences you have throughout your day and throughout all these different routines. The other thing about lighting is, because it's ubiquitous, it's also somewhat on the affordable side, you might say. So if you're going into the smart home to sort of figure out what you want to try as an experiment, you can simply buy a smart light bulb, right? And whichever control system you like, whether it's voice, an app, whatever it may be, and get your first taste of what a smart experience can be, and then build from that.
I love that commercial that GE has where all the people are talking to their light bulbs and asking for Alexa.
Right.
But of course, that is the commercial for the Soul, which was announced not too long ago, but it's all part of this whole ecosystem that you guys are introducing.
Right.
Can you
talk
a little bit about that product?
Sure.
And it's Alexa built in, so it's almost like a speaker as well.
Right. So as you said, it's called Soul. It's a C by GE Soul. It's the first lighting product to have Alexa voice assistant embedded. So it looks basically like a large ring, you might say. And the outer diameter emits light of multiple different sort of white colors, from a deep amber to sort of a sky blue. And the really amazing thing about it is that it's got, with the voice assistant embedded in the base of it, it's kind of an all-in-one product. So you can imagine it, for example, next to your bed. So it's a combination of your table lamp beside your bed, your clock there, your radio that might be there. If you had smart products, you might have a hub there. It's all built into one, which is really a sort of a great solution for people. It's got a very modern design. So we launched that in September, and we've gotten a wonderful reception so far with that product.
And it's interesting, we were talking offline earlier how this is almost like kind of the first product where it's beyond lighting. You're working in audio, there's health benefits from the coloring. You want to go a little bit more into that?
Oh, sure. It's really a bold statement for us as GE Lighting. You know, we've been around for over 105 years out there. And so for us to go from making the light bulbs people have known and trusted for a very long time into making what for us is the first time we've made a table lamp, essentially, and then to sort of say, well, let's really get into the fast lane of all these smart home products and embed a voice assistant into that, really was sort of a part of our transformation into the 21st century as we reinvent ourselves into a new kind of relevance to consumers and a whole new business model for our future.
Yeah, I mean, you've been around for 100 years. We all know GE Lighting for the bulbs, and I feel like this is the biggest transformation of sorts since the creation of the light bulb.
Well, it's you might certainly think of it that way. I mean, for us, lighting's transformed over the years from incandescent lighting that Edison was involved in many years ago to the fluorescent lighting that GE was part of developing, and then LED lighting. So even though LED lighting was developed back in the 50s, it didn't really come to fruition until, I believe, 5 or 7 years ago, and that started the transformation. So now people really have these incredibly long-living bulbs, great energy efficiency and so forth, but because it's semiconductor technology, that's what's allowing us to deliver these newer smart products that can give you different colors that really sort of make sense as part of these sort of amazing new value propositions for consumers.
So what trends are you guys seeing in the connected home for 2018 and maybe even the next few years?
Yeah, there are lots of things. So we touched on voice. So voice is really an incredibly intuitive interface for consumers. So when we launched in a smart home, we launched first on a platform that was largely app-driven, and we moved to the voice platform just very recently. We launched a Soul product in September. We launched a bridge in November in time for the holidays to enable all these voice systems to actually control our smart bulbs out there. And with that, it's really sort of given this sort of new step forward. So I think we'll continue to see great innovation from that standpoint, from the idea of voice. What we're also seeing are things like some of the key features. Like I mentioned the smart switch we launched.
Right.
One key feature of that is it's got an occupancy sensor in it. So now this next, I think, intuitive interface we're going to see is really your physical presence in a space. So, for many years we touched the wall, right? And more recently we could speak to the space. Now we can just enter the space, and that's going to trigger all these events. So, you know, simply it can trigger lighting, but beyond that, as now in these interconnected systems, so you can imagine, you know, our C by GE smart switch out there has Wi-Fi connection that can connect to your Alexa system, your Google Assistant, your HomeKit system out there, whatever system you're using out there, and that can trigger many other activities to happen in your home as really a cascade of these new experiences for people.
I'm glad you brought that up because you are embracing Alexa, Google Assistant, and HomeKit.
Right.
You're not picking one, and for me, I really appreciate that because there's so many Alexa products out there, and I'm a kind of a HomeKit user. I mean, maybe like the only HomeKit user.
Uh-huh. You're not the only one.
But so I'm really glad that you guys are making something that I could actually use.
I can speak to that. I think as you said, consumers want choice. And so our goal really is to give people what they want. So we're going to give them this incredibly valuable product and functionality. And depending upon whatever voice platform they want to be on, we're going to make that available to them.
Have we sold you on a connected home yet?
It's pretty impressive. I do like the fact that we're evolving the simplicity of our movements from actually physically needing to do things and then exerting ourselves by speaking. Now we don't have to do anything like that at all. We just go about our day-to-day lives.
Right.
I think that's great. Ferreno in the comments says, look, I love the changing color feature. How many colors do you have on the light? What's the variation of colors that we can get?
There's a wide range. So we change within the white spectrum. So this is really, if you can picture from sort of a high blue color, so if you know the Kelvin scale from your days in science class, 7,000 Kelvin is, no, not that, 7,000 Kelvin is one end of the range. Just picture the sort of a bright, sunny day. And that area has a hint of blue in it, to the sort of warm spectrum at the other end, which includes you pass through like daylight, bright white, white, soft white, to this sort of deep amber color at the bottom there to give you this whole spectrum. And one thing about the colors, to sort of build upon that, is those colors help you actually manage your sleep cycles. The high blue actually suppresses melatonin, so you can go about your daily routine. The deep amber allows it to rush back in. So what we recommend people do with the Sol table lamp or with our C-by-GE sleep bulb is you can use those technologies to actually help you sort of improve your sleep cycles overall.
Kind of balancing how we spend our last waking moments every night with this daylight blaring through us.
Mod, you got it. Right, exactly. So whichever technology you have on your phone there, whether it's a night shift technology or the efflux you might have running on your computer screen, you can use these things to help cut that blue light that sort of helps sort of mess with your sleep. But also you can create make your whole environment also help you get ready for bed at night.
Now, I sleep, I was going to say, with a big fan, but that sounds terrible. I like to have the fan on me, and you're saying that fans are a thing that you are including in ceiling lights. Are you actually going into sort of like the whole electric spectrum here?
Yes, exactly, yeah. Right. So I mentioned the two ceiling fixtures. So depending upon whatever room you may have, and many times people have the recessed can, the floodlights in the ceilings. Sometimes they have a surface mount, which is kind of a newer trend in lighting. But so now what we've announced is, one is you can put sound in them, and you can have them smart, you can have sound. We're also saying voice assistant within that.
Cool.
So we think that really you probably want to have at least one voice assistant sort of experience per room to control that experience. We're giving you more options. So whichever device you could have bought from some of the primary voice providers out there, we're giving you that in other form factors too.
So cool. Anivere, who's in the chat at the moment, because we are broadcasting all over YouTube, says, you know what, the science behind the lights is actually kind of cool.
Yeah.
Like knowing that there is science behind it, even though I tuned out of science when I was in school, the fact that it's coming into play here to actually help our bodies and have deep sleep, which is something that a lot of us have been struggling with. That's really, really cool.
I can comment on that a little bit. I mean, walking around the show has incredible themes around sleep, between mattresses that are sort of measuring your sleep quality, between devices that help you sort of maximize your sleep out there. It's a real trend. Arianna Huffington declared last year the year of sleep. And so I think there's a lot of science coming out for people that are really supporting the fact that we need to spend more time investing in the quality of our sleep because it affects the quality of our lives.
I've got a comment here from Dreamer who says that I want to talk about the pricing of GE products. Is it going to be more competitive than before?
Well, just to speak to that, so the C-by-GE Sol, the table lamp, we launched that with an MSRP of $199.99 in September, thought perfect price for everyone. But frankly, the whole market out there in terms of the voice assistants dropped in terms of pricing. You know, it's a competitive space. We lower the MSRP $50 to $149.99. During the holiday, the retailers put it on sale for $99.99 out there. So the goal is to make these, very hot price, right? So again, we're trying to make these things very accessible to people out there so that they can really have these experiences. And it's a very fast moving space. So what you'll see is that as the price, for example, of LED, good old fashioned LED light bulbs dropped from $40 a piece in 2011 to, you can get them between $1 and $3 right now in 2018, right? We see consumer electronics products dropping quickly too. And so our products continue to sort of develop new ways to lower the cost, to improve adoption and make it easier for people to buy them.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for joining us here at Digital Trends at CES. Amazing. And if people want to learn more about the GE and what's happening at CES, where can people find that information?
We have our website, which is cbyge.com. Talks about our whole full product line of GE smart light bulbs and related products.
Fantastic. And of course, if you do want to know what's happening with CES and everything that Les has been writing furiously throughout the last 3 days, head to digitaltrends.com/CES. We've got one last thing to wrap things up here at CES. It is called the DT wrap-up, basically. Greg's going to come back on board and we're going to talk about all the big things that have happened throughout all of CES 2018. Don't go anywhere.
Thanks, Jeff.